Hello students, today we are going to start the sixth chapter, that is a speech coding from the information theory and coding. So speech is a very crucial or very special type of the signal for the different reasons, because first one is it is a non-stationary signal or random signal. Speech signal is very hard to analyze and modelize. The next reason is factor like its intelligence, coherence and other such a characteristic which plays a vital role in the analysis of the speech signal. And the third reason, in the communication point of view, that there are many different discrete levels are required to sample the 1 second of the speech signal. That is 8,000 samples are required for the 1,000 of the speech signal. And the next reason is the bandwidth parameter, which affects the cost processing of the speech signal, which are subjected to compress before transmission. So the as point of the bandwidth requirement, the speech signal compress before the transmission. So speech coding or compression is a process of obtaining the compact representation of the speech signal for the purpose of efficient transmission over a band limited wired or wireless channel, and also for the storage, efficient storage. In the recent days, the speech coder becomes essential component for the telecommunication and multimedia, as the utilization of the bandwidth affects the cost transmission. And the goal of speech coding is to represent the sample of the speech signal with minimum number of bits without any reduction in the perceptual quality. So the speech coding or compression done for the efficient transmission of the speech signal over wired or wireless channel for the efficient storage. And in recent days, the bandwidth utilization is one of the major parameters. So for the efficient storage, speech coding speech should be the coded or compressed without any reduction of its quality. And the speech coding helps a telephone company to carry out the voice over a call or the on a single fiber link or cable. The speech coding is very important in case of the mobile as well as telecommunication for the lower data rates, as well as the speech coding is also used for the VoIP, that is voice over IP, video conferencing and different multimedia application. In addition, the speech coding requires the minimum coding delay, because long coding delays hidden the flow of the speech conversion. Speech coder is one which converts the digitized speech signal into the coded representation. So in the speech coding, there is a signal should be digitized and after it is coded and transmit in the forms of the frame, so over a different channel. And at the receiving, the speech decoder receives the coded frame, perform the synthesize operation and reconstruct that speech signal. Speech coder differs primarily in bit rate, complexity, delay, perceptual quality of the synthesized speech. There exist two type of the coding technique: narrow band speech coding and wide band speech coding. Narrow band speech coding refers coding of the speech signal whose bandwidth is in between the 300 to 3400 Hz with the sampling rate 8 kHz. While in wideband coding, that is the next band of the coding frequency, in wideband coding of the speech signal whose bandwidth less than 50 to 7000 Hz, that is with the 14 to 16 kHz sampling rate. Narrowband speech coding is more common than the wideband speech coding of the narrowband nature of the telephone channel lines and whose bandwidth lies between the 300 to 3400 Hz. And in recent day, there is an increase in demand for the wideband speech coding technique in the application like a video conferencing. So in case of the video conferencing or multimedia, there is a wideband speech coding is there. But in case of the voice calling or in the telephone lines, channel lines, there is a narrow band speech coding refers. The steps involving the speech coding is, first one is the speech analysis. In speech analysis, it involves framing, windowing, overlapping of the framings, calculation of the linear predictive coefficients, estimation of the pitch of the frame, conversion of the linear predictive coefficients of line LPC to line spectral frequency parameters. These are we are going to check in the next presentation slides. Vector quantization, this is the one of the steps involving the speech coding. It involves the design of code books using the Lindow-Bezout-Gray algorithm, design of various vector quantizer, and the implementation of the vector quantization on the line spectral frequencies. The next step is the speech synthesis. It involves the conversion of the line spectral frequencies to the linear predictive coefficient and performs the synthesis using the pitch gain and quantize the LPC parameter. So these are the three steps: speech analysis, vector quantization, and speech synthesis have the some characteristic for the speech coding operation. In the other steps are the spectral distortion, outliner, and unsettable frames. Next, this is the typical figure of the block diagram of the speech coding system. Here the input is a speech which may be the analog. After it is given to the filter, then for the sampler or sampling and hold circuit, because the signal is in the analog, and after the samples are available, if that samples is given to the A to D converter, after the source converter, channel encoder, and after the coded frames is given to the channel, where the channel may be the wired or wireless. After that, the receiving side, the channel decoder is there, where decoding and synthesizing operation is done. After source decoder, after the original signal should be retrieved, so D2A converter is used, and after the filter, you will get the output speech. So this is the typical block diagram of the speech coding system. In speech coding system, initially the input speech signal, which is analog in nature, is digitized using the filter, sampler, and analog to digital converter circuit. Filter is an antenna analyzing filter, which is low pass filter used before the sampler to remove the all signal frequencies that are above the Nyquist frequency. So this filter is an anti-analyzing filter. The filtering is done to avoid the problem of the aliasing. If the speech sampling frequency is less than the twice of the bandwidth of the sampled speech signal, the problem of aliasing will occur. So for maintaining the Nyquist criteria, the filter is used. The best solution to aliasing is to make the sampling frequency greater than 2.5 times of the bandwidth. So sampling frequency should be greater than Nyquist bandwidth, or as per the Nyquist criteria, 2.5 times of the bandwidth of the analog speech signal. According to the Nyquist theorem, sampling frequencies must be at least twice the bandwidth of the continuous time signal in order to avoid the aliasing. The sampler, after the sampler converts the analog speech signal into the discrete form, and it will be given to A to D converter, whose output is digitized speech signal. Most speech coding systems were designed to support the telecommunication application in the frequency between 300 to 3400 Hz. And to convert the analog speech signal to the digital format, the minimum perceptual quality, and to make the digital speech indistinguishable from the input, it is necessary to sample the speech signal with more than 8 bit per sample. So the speech, the function of source coder is to reduce the bit rate. The coding algorithm is used to thesis for the reduction of the bit rate is a linear predictive algorithm, and the output of source encoder is given to the channel encoder, which provides the error protection to the bit stream transmitted over the communication channel, where noise and interference can reduce the reliability of the transmitted data. And at the receiving end, the channel decoder recovers the coded data and protects from the error, and will be fed to the source decoder, so recover the original speech signal. And later the speech signal is fed to the digital to analog converter to convert the speech signal from the digital to analog format. And finally, analog speech signal is fed to the anti-aliasing filter to prevent the aliasing effect during the reconstruction of the continuous signal from the speech samples. And that again requires the perfect stop band rejection to guaranteed zero aliasing. So the next one is the attributes of the speech coders. The aim of speech coding is to enhance the quality of the speech signal at a particular bit rate or minimum bit rate with the good quality. The bit rate at which speech is to be transmitted or stored depends upon the rate of transmission or storage. The computation of the coding, the digital signal and the coding of the speech signal is required. Hence, desirable properties of the speech coder include. So these are the some properties. The first property or attribute is the low bit rate. The lower bit rate of an encoded bit stream is the lesser is the bandwidth requirement for the transmission. So for any speech coding or speech compression, there should be the lower data rate or lower bit rate so that the there may be the minimum bandwidth requirement. But any reduction in the bit rate results in the loss of the quality of the speech signal, which is undesirable. So if you go on reducing the bit rate, so there may be the some quality of the speech signal may be degraded. So a trade-off must be maintained between the reduction of the bit rate and quality of the speech signal depending upon the intended application. So depending upon the application, so you can decide the bit rate of the signal with the good quality of the signal. So you can take the example for the MP3 signal. So while recording of this song, there may be the higher bit rate, but after the compression of that signal, the data rate may get changed. Next attributes is the high speed quality. The decoded speech signal must have the high quality and must be suitable for the intended application. So decoding signals have the good quality and it is suitable for the intended application or required application. The quality of the speech signal depends on the factor like intelligibility, naturalness and speaker recognizability. Next is the robustness to the different speaker and language. The speech coder must be general enough so that it is used for any type of the speaker like a male, female, children, and it can also used for any kind of the languages. But it is not trivial task because every voice signal has its own characteristics. So different voice signals has the different characteristic depending upon the male, female as well as children. So it's the speech algorithm or speech coding should be the robustness to the different speakers or compatible with the different speaker and language. Next is the channel errors, robustness to the channel error. This is crucial for the digital communication system where the channel errors have a negative impact on the quality of the speech signal. So the next one is the low memory size and computational complexity. In order to have the good marketability of the speech coder and the cost associated with its implementation must be as low as possible. So it should be the cost should be the as low as possible. The cost of the product depends upon the memory required to support its operation and computational complexity. So the speech coder must have the lower memory requirement and the computational complexities to have the better marketability. So this is one of the attribute or characteristic. And the next one is the low coding delay. The coding delay is the time elapsed from the time the speech samples arrives at the encoder input to the time speech samples appear at the decoder output. An excessive delay creates the problem in the real-time two-way communication. So the coding time delay as low as possible. The next objective is the speech coding. The objective of the speech coding is to compress the speech signal by reducing the number of bits per sample or bit rate such that the coded speech is audibly indistinguishable from the original speech signal. And specifically speech coding methods achieve the following gain. The first one is the reduction in bit rate to or equivalent bandwidth, the first aim. Second objective is the reduction in the memory requirement, which decreases in the proportionate manner with respect to bit rate. And third one is the reduction in the transmission power requirement. That is, compressed speech signal has less number of bits per second to transmit. And the next one is immune to noise. Sum of saved bits per sample can be used as a protective error control bits to the speech parameter. So thank you. In next slides, next presentation, we are going to check the speech coding, different speech coding method. Thank you.